Hello, and welcome to Strain Theory 101. In this video, we will learn what strain theory is, some things that could cause strain, and how it affects individuals in society. Strain theory assumes that humans are inherently good. Humans are a noble savage, which means that in our primitive state, we are social and we like each other. The only way that we betray that pro-social instinct is if circumstances cause society to fail us. It may be that we live in poverty, or the current context of our situation is that we are normally well-meaning, kind people, but because of situational factors, we're feeling stress or strain, and that causes us to betray our pro-social nature. In terms of explaining crime, there is not a direct connection between feeling strain and acting out. There are actually a couple of states in between that make folks even more likely to do so. The three states are the inability to achieve positively valued goals, the presence of negative stimuli, and the anticipated removal of positive stimuli. An example of the inability to achieve positively valued goals is somebody who can't buy the big house or the nice car that they want because they do not have the means to do so, such as education or a good job to get the money. An example of the presence of negative stimuli is that somebody may live in a bad neighborhood and may be surrounded by negative influences that cause strain. An example of the anticipated removal of positively valued stimuli could include the breakup of a marriage or relationship. Breakups can cause people to do things that they would not do in other circumstances. So again, the three sources of strain are the inability to achieve goals, presence of negative stimuli, and the anticipated removal of positive stimuli. When strain is experienced, the most direct effect is negative emotion like anger, frustration, or depression. When we feel the effects of this strain, we use something called legitimate coping mechanisms. These can be things like working out, playing sports, playing an instrument, or religion, like praying. If you have some sort of legitimate coping mechanism, then you can relieve some of that negative effect of strain. If you don't, or the only things offered to you are illegitimate coping mechanisms, then that will lead to delinquency. Because these delinquents do not have any way to relieve their strain, they tend to do things that are against the law, like vandalizing something that isn't theirs, or getting really frustrated and hitting someone. They feel good when they are able to release this built-up stress, otherwise known as strain. Some may be so strained to achieve positively valued goals that they are willing to do illegal things to obtain money, like stealing or selling drugs. The big take-home message is that we betray our pro-social nature when the environment causes us to experience strain or stress, and when we experience strain, our emotions take over. If we don't have some sort of legitimate release or legitimate coping mechanisms to those emotions, then we are going to do something that is out of character and antisocial. In this video, we learned the definition of strain theory, the three causes of strain and what they are, and the ways that strain can affect individuals in society. Thank you very much for watching, and remember to have a strain-free day.